We're now ready to talk about the main categories into which receptors are placed. Receptors are often classified into superfamilies. We're going to talk about four superfamilies. Not all receptors fit into these four categories, these four superfamilies. But if you're working in drug discovery, you should be familiar with these four superfamilies because most drug targets do fall within these categories. First superfamily, the G protein coupled receptors, or GPCRs. GPCRs are found in cell membranes. Ligands bind on the extracellular face. The signal of ligand binding is communicated across the membrane so that the cell can make an appropriate response. GPCRs are also called 7 transmembrane domain receptors. Because the time from ligand binding to response is relatively long, ligands that bind GPCRs are sometimes called slow neurotransmitters. Second superfamily, ion channel linked receptors. Ion channels are found in cell membranes. Ligand binding can open or close the ion channel. The flow of ions through a channel is very fast, and ligands that open ion channels are often called fast neurotransmitters. Third superfamily, the tyrosine kinase-linked receptors, or TLKRs. TLKRs are membrane-bound. Tyrosine kinase-linked receptors bind to ligands, and then the receptors bind to each other to form dimers. As a dimer pair, the receptors become active and communicate a signal across the cell membrane. TLKRs are often growth factors and targeted by cancer drugs. Fourth superfamily, the nuclear receptors. Nuclear receptors are not found in the cell membranes. Instead, they are found in the nucleus. Nuclear receptors often affect a broad range of responses in a cell, including gene expression. Steroids are ligands of nuclear receptors. We've now seen the superfamilies, which contain member proteins, and these proteins, these receptors, are the most common targets for drugs that you see day to day.